barbecue. So when you hear the music, it means only one thing now. The Apprentice is back. The 13th series of the show started last night. 18 new candidates being put through their paces by Lord Sugar and his team. And where would he be without his no-nonsense right-hand woman, Karen Brady? Delighted.
Yeah, Lady Brady is with us. Our right-hand woman this morning.
Today.
Good morning.
So you don't eat breakfast?
I don't. No, I haven't had breakfast for about 20 years. I can't eat breakfast. Can't eat in the morning. I like my coffee. I like to go through my emails. I'm not a great breakfast.
Does that mean you get to lunchtime and you're absolutely ravenous?
Yeah, probably. Feast or famine. Yeah, that's me.
Now we don't want to give away any spoilers because we know that people like to watch this. It doesn't matter how far away from the programme you talk about we're always accused
somebody.
Of spoilers. But what were the highlights last night? It was a burger bonanza, wasn't it?
It certainly was. I mean, one of the interesting things is they decide to go for things like luxury burgers and then buy the cheapest meats.
Yeah.
And the only thing that's luxury about it is the lettuce that goes into the actual burger. But of course, you're talking about throwing people together, asking them to come up with skills they haven't done before, get on, cook, sell, make, and... You know, MasterChef, it's not.
No, one of the fundamental parts of the challenge is always the selling. So it's crucial.
Oh, we just cut out of that at the point where the meat was going.
Yeah, you can see that. But the selling is crucial.
Yes.
And the fact that the boys mistimed their sales pitch, so when they got to their burger stand, there was actually no customers.
Yes.
It was fundamentally going to be a problem, wasn't it?
Well, absolutely. Most people buy burgers for lunch and the lunchtime trade, but when you get to your selling location after lunch, people are not really having it at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so there was no one there.
So it's series 18. I mean, how many have you done now? Eight or nine?
Eight, I think.
So you've done eight or nine. Do you still get the same sort of sense of interesting and excited anticipation when you start, or is it a little bit like, oh, gosh, what are we going to have this year?
No, it's fantastic. I mean, it's such a great show. There's nothing like it on television. It's business at the core of it, sometimes how not to do business, just as important how to do business. But no, we have a really good time, and it's really interesting. And I think one of the most remarkable things about the show is the prize is life-changing. At the beginning of this episode, you see the previous winners.
Yeah.
£250,000 a month turnover, £800,000 profit this year. In between them, they employ 100 people.
I know Lord Sugar was really keen, wasn't he, to sort of talk about the successes.
But you're talking about people that have set up the business of their dreams, in charge of their own destiny, running their own business, changing them and their families' lives, and nothing on TV does that.
I always admire the people who put themselves forward as project manager, because if you win, how fantastic, you get all the glory, and if you lose, you don't necessarily go home to the contestant's house.
Yes.
You might go home in a cab. Let's talk about a different PM, the Prime Minister, yesterday.
Yes.
Your show is all about leadership.
Yep.
What do you think she's like as a leader as a result of that speech?
Well, I think it was very unfortunate. I mean, I thought that was a ridiculously offensive stunt that the guy pulled. He calls himself a comedian, but it certainly wasn't funny. I think the set falling apart, the cough. I mean, you have to call it what it was. I mean, it was a bit of a nightmare.
If this was a task on The Apprentice, Karen, she would be in the firing
I think the most difficult thing for her is that she had wanted to make a speech that showed her authority, that showed that she was in charge, that pulled everybody together, and everything, frankly, that could have gone wrong went wrong. And, you know, you're talking about somebody that you're difficult, you're trying to lead, it looks as though you haven't got the full support of your cabinet or all of your MPs. And I think she's having a difficult morning. But the most important thing to do when that happens is to take control, deliver the promises she has made, get on with running the country and give us some sort of stability and a route through Brexit.
All right. There we must leave it.
Yeah.
Karen, thanks for coming in this morning.
My pleasure.
Great to see you. Oh, good morning, Britain. Back tomorrow from 6. Now it's time to join Lorraine.